I'm Cindy Souter, and we're at Sacred Threads 2015. I'm standing in front of my quilt, Homecoming, which was originally made for a special exhibit with the group Fiber Artists at Loose Ends. They had issued a challenge for an identity crisis collection of quilts, which was a topic near and dear to my heart. I think we all think about these questions. Who am I? Why am I here? Where do I belong? And in answering those questions, I realized I belong in all things Celtic. Celtic mythology, Celtic music, Celtic geographic locations. I felt very at home in front of Stonehenge when we visited. And so I wanted to make a quilt based on all of that. In this case, I am in the black cloak because I am the figure that doesn't quite know what's going on, is seeking answers, and that is apparently where I'm going to seek the answers. This quilt also celebrated an event in my life where I don't want to say I found religion. Religion may have found me, but I had been searching since I was 10 for a religion that felt authentic. I was playing with Wicca, thought that maybe that's where I belonged. I had read Drawing Down the Moon by Margot Adler. And in making this quilt, I recalled an incident that really was the event that convinced me that Wicca is where I belong. Again, another kind of homecoming. I had spent the day at the hospital with my mother. Very difficult day, difficult relationship, difficult everything. I was on my way home, and I was angry. And I was pouring out all of that anger and vitriol and disappointment and frustration to the world and whatever spirits were listening. And as I drove, this moon was following me. It was a bright night. It was wonderful, except for in the car where I was very unhappy, pounding my fist on my steering wheel and just yelling to the four corners. And the moon, as I said, was following me. And all of a sudden, after all of this tirade about my mother and how she had not been there and not protected me, all of the knots in the world that we mourn, the moon seemed to get a little brighter, and I heard this voice in my head as clearly as I am speaking to you now. I'm your mother. I still get chills when I think about the moment. And that was a real turn of events for me, and that is spirituality for me. There are a lot of questions about the quilt construction, and I'll quickly just address the elephant in the room because that's the moon. I had a rubber stamp that I liked very much of a moon, and I enlarged it and then changed it, and at the end it's not even recognizable, but it was my starting point. And I had this moon, and I used a pen and made dots, stippling in the old art version of stippling, not as we quilters think of stippling, and then quilted it very lightly, so that it would not have wrinkles in its face. And the rest of it's really pretty standard. So thank you for listening to my story about my quilt.